Welcome back. Now, we're talking about stuff married people do. Sleeping together is an integral part of any married couple's relationship, we think, and is sometimes the only quality time that couples get to spend time with each other. Well, recently, many couples maintained separate, maintained separate bedrooms as a sign of affluence and status. It was late in the 19th century that bed sharing became popular and the standard for married couples. A study for National Sleep Foundation, found that 24% of couples sleep in separate rooms. And another study, the National Association of Home Builders, report that since 1990, the number of requests for homes with two master bedrooms has increased. And that by 2015, up to 60% of upscale homes will have dual master bedrooms and bathrooms. So is your nocturnal incompatibility a sign of emotional distance? Should couples sleep separately? It's your view. Let it count. You can call us on 070-8066-8044. You can tweet to us at YourViewTBC. Let's hear your thoughts on this. So who is married here? Nimo. So what's the system like in your house?
We share a bedroom.
You share a bedroom. Okay. Jabless, are you married?
Yes.
Do you share a bedroom?
Yes.
Wow, I don't share a bedroom.
Why?
You don't?
No,
I don't. Please give us the gist.
So, don't make me the topic of this.
We want to know.
But no, because honestly, the reason. Okay, let me tell you. Let me. You want to start with me or I start with you?
We start with you.
Hot topic. Just say hi to Jabless.
Yeah. Jabless is in the house. Yay. We're going to introduce you probably in the next segment. Okay. Yeah. So, okay. We're just going to. One day he's just joined the conversation.
Yeah, I feel
YK,
blessed.
Yes, go ahead. Let me hear your thoughts.
About sharing the bedroom?
Yes.
Well, I think at the beginning of the marriage, yeah. You know, when it's still very fresh, you could share a bedroom.
Yeah.
But when you start getting old, you have things to keep, you have personal things, I think you can now have separate rooms.
That was exactly that's
like when you, yeah. You know, get into
I think that's what happened to us. Initially, too, we had the same bedroom. We were perfect. When the child, when my daughter came in, she was sleeping with us, right? And I don't want to turn on the AC for sometimes, or the fan is too much. And I was like, I'm hot. Like, yeah, go to the guest room now, you know? And he'll turn on the AC full blast. And he'll be all right. But in our room, I prefer that the temperature is a bit lower. Just open the windows, because sometimes she has cough. And she's sneezing all through the night. I can't say because daddy wants AC. And now put AC on my daughter's head. Of course not. So daddy should find his place and find somewhere else. And he kind of now got used to that thing. And now say, you know what? Although I was totally against it. I said, this is the guest room. It's not your room. After a while, I said, well, take it to my room. Meet me in my room. And I'm like, how, you know? So it's kind of now getting, we're
okay,
not getting
it.
Slowly moved out.
So when, you know, like,
she
action,
will go to the guest room.
Do you make appointments? I need to know now. Because nobody's supposed to be a romantic. Do you make appointments?
I grew up with my parents.
I need to understand.
Let me explain it.
Okay, that's because he sleeps in his room does not mean that we don't hang out together. He comes to my room, we're there all through. Sometimes I go to the other room, we're there all through. When it's now time to sleep. But we're doing the other one here. We know where you can, any area.
Okay, there's no appointment.
I grew up with my parents having separate bedrooms, and when it was time for the action, they didn't need appointments. It's just to take me from my mother's bedside to my father's bedroom, and that's all.
Did you know why they were taking you?
I can remember very well.
You knew what was going to happen?
At that time, I didn't know what was. It's now that I
just realized that, okay, they just carry you.
So this is the reason why they used to take me to the other room. Now I know.
And how old were you?
I was young. I think I slept in my mom's room till I was about 9 or thereabouts.
I can't stand this whole system. I really don't like it. So I've started in my daughter's room right now. In fact, the carpenter is bringing her bed this weekend, hopefully. I'm trying to move her.
I actually wanted to say that was what you should have done in the first place.
Right.
Instead of him leaving the room for you and your daughter. Like, yeah. Your daughter was supposed to excuse you guys.
Yeah, yeah. But you see, when you, you have a brand new baby, you want your baby to be next to you.
Yes. I want to cuddle my baby all the time.
Boy, your baby.
You prefer to cuddle your baby or you cuddle your man?
I prefer to cuddle my baby. My husband, he knows. You see, when we growing up, I had sisters and we had to share a bed. I always had problems whenever someone is sleeping with me. So when I got married, I needed to adjust. My husband took his time to lecture me that this is our bedroom, sleep here. Hmm. I would sleep at night, I would just find myself sleeping somewhere else. I would just move out so that I would get my beauty sleep. Yeah. I would move out quietly. So later he started moving with me because we had a two-bedroom.
Your husband
is nice, so you cannot marry somebody like me. You cannot marry somebody like me.
What would you have preferred?
You pull her back.
24/7, everything is together.
When your baby needs to be cuddled, maybe they're not feeling very well. They're ill. Don't you think your wife should actually?
This moment comes.
Okay.
But it's like
cuddle, and when she sleeps, put her in her cradle and go back to your room.
You're supposed to cuddle me. When
my husband kept moving with me, I adjusted and we started staying in the room. Our baby took some time to come, and then when she finally came, I just didn't know how it happened. Because I need to feed her at night. She had a little bed in the room with us. I will still move her from that bed to the
bed.
And you know, he kept complaining. I will listen today, I'll do it again tomorrow. And at a point, he just came home from work. He bought a big bed for her. See, rebellious. He just moved her to that salon. This is the bed. And
yes,
then you notice that at night, I'll crawl there again.
Aww.
I'll be sleeping there. I'm
sorry for your husband, though. I'm very sorry for your husband. Because, you know, I was married before. And let me tell you, it causes the couples to drift apart. Because I moved to my daughter's room. And my husband would have to come and sleep in my room. My ex-husband would have to come and sleep in my room. But I was more my daughter. So we just drifted apart.
Sure.
Because, there is nothing you and your partner...
As a matter of fact, if you look at what...
If you do like that with your child, you can go and smother your child and kill your child. So, let the child sleep.
No, as a matter of fact, if you look at what the men, what we do from morning till night, trying to take care of you guys, that's night time. It's your time to take care of us.
True. Okay, let me take John's call. Good morning, John.
I'm coming back to you.
Hello, are you there? Thanks for calling. John. Hello, John.
Hello, I'm on the line.
Good morning. How are you?
Fine.
So do you sleep in separate rooms or the same room?
We sleep in the same room.
Really? Yes, so.
I read one of the articles on the paper about the death of Aulao. Had it been his wife slept with him in his room, he would have not died.
Yeah.
Because he was alone in his room, that's why he died.
Yeah.
It is good for two persons, even if not the wife or the husband, either if the child, the grown-up, that kind of sense, okay, something happened at night that can raise alarm. But if one person should be sleeping, okay, for instance, you said your husband sleeps in the room because he lost AC. And you know AC is so dangerous at night that it can go high, anything can happen. So if he's the only person there, God forbid if anything negative should happen, how would other people that are in other rooms get?
That's an extreme case, though. Thank you very much, John, for that call.
It's not extreme, though.
Where do people die? Because you're
the extreme, but what of illness? Somebody's ill and they just need attention. He can't call out, he can't shout, you're in the next room. But if you're on the same bed, he can't tap you.
What if a single person comes?
She said, thank God for GSM. She said, yeah, we.
It's true now. I thought you were a liar. It's true that sometimes my husband
flash.
I call my husband. It's true. I call my husband from the other room, he comes over. Even at night, I call him and he comes
take
over.
Care of us. They work out to take care of us. I take care of my husband 24/7. I don't have a maid. I cook. I do everything. So when I want my me time, I
want to sleep.
And I just love that the feel of my
baby's
skin on my
skin. For me, I never really wanted him to go. He was one. I said, Mira, I can't sleep in this hot. This is too much heat.
I agree.
This heat. He needs AC.
Put the baby in her own room.
I'm not saying you think I don't want AC. Well, I'm making a sacrifice because of my daughter.
Answer, Mariah. You see, your baby would have slept separately in another room. Then because. That AC will not be affecting you if you are holding your husband.
God will bless you.
Bless you.
You will be close.
AC
will warm.
So that you can come closer.
That is why there is AC.
I agree with having. Okay.
Let me take this call. Henry. Go good morning, Henry. How are you?
Yeah, good Thanks morning, Morayo.
Separate or together?
We sleep together. But because of house problem in Lagos, That is why we are sleeping together. But in my hometown, where I build my own house, we have separate bedrooms. Mm. But let me tell you, it has a lot of meaning. One, you know, women are obungongo. That is, they used to get properties. Handbag, shoes, this and that in this corner, front box in this corner. The whole room will be congested with their own properties. You understand?
Okay.
That is one of the reasons. But yeah. I support the idea of sleeping together because you will not give that woman the chance of making, for example, this midnight call. And there are some important topics that we will discuss when you are in bed. So that is my own view. So I support the idea of sleeping together. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I support Henry's position. I was just going to say, I support separate rooms for property. Jeez, you know, these women with our Uwambe, you know, all your shoes, your bags, men can get, this clutter is too much.
I have a separate house.
So have a separate room for bags, for shoes, for clothes, where you go to get dressed. But for sleeping sleep on the same bed.
I find that my husband actually always comes to my room all the time. Even last night, he slept in my room.
Yeah.
Though my daughter was there. But I know he gets very lonely over there.
Yeah. It's lonely now. I didn't get married to be sleeping alone. John Tori alone. Do you understand? It promotes intimacy. And then when you have separate bedrooms, when you quarrel, you will move to your own bed. But when there's no other bed, when you are sleeping on this side and that side, then one person can now say,
That's very true. When I was on my wedding day, I remember a deaconess came from my wedding, my family friend. My father's best friend is a deacon. He's a professor in Ife. So she came for the wedding and she was like, I'm advising you, Nima. Small hostel bed. That's what you should go and get. So that when your husband and you are quarreling, Emma Jarokwalu, I get possible. So, you know, she gave me all that advice.
It's hard for you to make a brand new baby go into her room. It's really difficult because as a mother, you want to take care of the child. At least now that she's 2+, I'm willing to actually move her.
The America that you came from, don't they have babies before the baby is born? A baby's room.
Yes, though.
So why do you
have baby monitor?
Why do you forget that tradition?
I actually wanted to get a monitor. I wanted to get a monitor before, you know, electric,
No, the monitors in Nigeria use batteries now.
Mariah, you're not American. Mothers used to keep us close by.
And again, my husband is from Ekiti.
He's
an Ekiti man.
And complain on his behalf.
He's complaining already. Let me take money. He was like, I know
we'll come to Jabless very, because we need to really dig into his own thoughts on this issue. But let's first of all take this call. Good morning, Mercy.
Good morning, Mariah.
Yes, sir. Oh, Nelson. Sorry about
Nelson,
that.
Yeah, Nelson, yeah.
So, Mariah, together or apart?
Together.
Before that, let me, I have an observation. I have an observation, please.
Go ahead.
Okay, Jumoke should learn to address the president with some courtesy. You cannot be a prosecutor and a judge of the case. You are presenting a show. Each time there's an issue about the president, the way you talk about him and mention his name, address him, it looks so insulting. I don't like that. Okay. We are human beings, for Christ's sake. If you are doing that to my elder brother or my younger brother, I wouldn't even appreciate it. So let her learn how to address and talk about with the president.
Point taken. Please. Thanks. Thank you very much.
And again, about this issue of living apart, as I'm talking to you now, I'm in my bedroom. My wife has her. If she wants to come over, she comes over. Because of the issue of load, where we moved, we are living before, we are living at a two-bedroom in Ibadan. The room is so congested. Rapper here, this one there, shoes there, everything is just like that. Now we move back to Bagada, we're living in a bigger apartment. So she has enough space. At first, she was very, very angry. She thought maybe this man is just wicked. I said, no. Stay there with me.
I agree with her.
I have my
so,
own.
But if you want, if both of you want to get together, who goes to whose room? Does she have to come
over?
You
hear what she said? If she wants to come over, she comes over.
She comes over.
You are not even romantic at all.
Big sister, I'm sorry about that. But at least pain and comfort. We cannot be sopping ourselves in one bedroom. You know, everywhere gets stopped. You know, you stop.
Hey, you keep our things in another room, but you sleep together in one room.
You know, and we just got married recently. So.
The more is
not right. So romantic.
Okay, thank you very much, Nelson. Have a blessed marriage. Yes, God bless. So let me hear your thoughts on this.
I think I understand Nelson's view as a man, because sometimes the woman you marry can actually determine how you're going to position the situation, in sense that, okay, she has too many stuffs, the room is congested, there is no space to breathe. You rather get a room.
Yeah.
Then another thing, if you marry a woman that can talk, you know, you women.
Does your wife talk?
No, she doesn't.
Yeah, okay.
But I have friends that are married to somebody that can talk. At night, they would be like,
so you need that.
More first room!
I got to call you.
And they'll still wake you up like, you have to listen. I have to tell you this. You know, situations like that, you could just like, okay,
can in my room.
Keep your room. Let me keep my own. You get, if you want
I
to
know,
do that thing.
I was talking to a husband yesterday, I think one of the producers, he was saying that the reason why he likes to keep his own room is because he likes the idea of going to knock on his wife's door.
Ah.
Can I call me? He doesn't want it to be as if she's just always there. She's not available. He wants to be as if he's constantly chasing her. Come and say, wait, can I come in? You know, that kind of thing. Is it all right? You know, that's
what happens for. What happens if they fight for 2 weeks? He won't knock at all.
In my own situation, my partner, because we don't live together, all my property are in my house. All the property I have, you know, all my
right
clothes.
Here, your clothes are plenty.
My partner would have started fighting if I had moved all my clothes to his house. Yeah. So I have my clothes in a separate house, very few in his own house. But when we are together, we sleep together.
All right, let me take Thomas' call.
And we hold each other back.
Thomas, let me take your call. Good morning, Thomas. Are you there? Only men are calling this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Oga. Thanks for calling.
Yes,
together or separate?
Together.
Ah,
I don't like separate. I like your show this morning.
Okay.
Well, in as much I do agree with you, but today I don't agree with you. I agree with Timoke and TME, which says you have to stay together, because sometimes when you don't stay together, you find out that there is kind of a leakage in the relationship.
Yeah.
So I abide in a way whereby Timoke said they should stay together. And moreover, Timoke, don't get upset about what the last caller said and all that. I like your contribution, but you have to be very more careful in your objective. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Thomas.
We have a few tweets.
Yes.
Ima says, what will we say about the poor people who don't have more rooms to sleep? Abimbola says, it's sweeter for couples to sleep in the same room. It increases their bond. But we ladies have luggage, Joe. It's a personal opinion. Raymond says, no.
From personal experience.
Many do. It's just so not right, especially the old school couples. They do a lot, and such families tend to drift apart a lot. That's sleeping separately. Aji Lawal says, I support them to share the same bedroom. Jumoke, I really enjoy your positive points. Didi says, couples should sleep together. I grew up seeing my parents in the same room with me, most times in the middle. Love you, ladies. Azizo says, no. It does not show the sign of love and the meaning of being one marriage. Everyone is saying to sleep together.
And I just need to quarrel with Jabless, because he's saying these ladies talk a lot. Can you imagine? Not men don't talk.
Not every lady.
They like to give you gist. Like, wants me to gist him every day and wants to know every single thing. That information. So what happened when you got to work?
Yeah.
So what did you see?
So what time do you have to talk all the time? Okay, you guys will be in the same bedroom before then. He's sleeping that she goes separate.
I have a last call. Victory. Good morning.
Good to see you, Mariah.
Good morning. Thanks for calling. No woman called us this morning.
Hey, Jimmy. Good morning.
So, together or apart?
Single.
Ah.
So, hoping, but I will advocate for together.
Okay.
Not apart.
Okay.
Mariah, honestly, Nigerian case is that of who is fooling who. You understand? Evaluate the amount spent on subsidy, and how much it costs to build a new refinery, which can be built and completed within a year.
God bless you.
And I don't understand. Thank you, Junie.
Sir?
Thanks for your argument yesterday. An unlawful adoption is a global crime. Mariah, you have the Western orientation because you schooled abroad. You should know that. So, stealing is stealing. There's no way you can say big or small stealing. Honestly, everything Jumoke said yesterday, honestly, I really appreciate it.
Okay.
I love it.
Thank you very much.
Wonderful weekend.
Victory. Have a last call for this morning. So, ladies,
thank you.
Very, very well. I think we had a good conversation on this. When we come back, we're going to focus.
Who won now?
We won together. I agree with sleep together. Just the circumstances. I'm moving my daughter to her room.
Move back.
I'm moving to her room.
You know, there are many thieves outside.
I'll come back after the show. Please bring that thing to me.
Bring the bed today. I'm
happy today because my daughter is with grandma for this week.
Nice one. So, no excuse to not cuddle anyone else.
All right.
I need to meet your husband.
Celebrity interview is next. Stay with us. We'll be right back.